make sure you're tucking. You have to cover your head. The cap. It should cover your ears. That's how we wear the cap. So we shouldn't wear the cap with our ears what? Exposed. I'm set. I have to do social hand washing. And know your demarcations. In the hospital setting, we have two areas. We have the low risk area and we have the high risk area. The low risk is where we store and we keep the PPEs and we don't own the PPEs. And the high risk is where when you finish, you remove. So for this practice that we are going through, this place is my low risk area and this place is my high risk area. I'm going to do the social hand washing, but I'm going to use the sanitizer to do that because I've washed my hands with what, the soap and water already. But when I'm done and I remove the PPEs and I remove the glove, I'm going to use soap and water. Why? Because anytime you remove a glove, you have to use soap and water to wash your hands, not sanitizer. So I'm going to perform social hand washing and don on what? My PPE. With the coverall, when you are going to wear it, you need a chair and you need a supervisor. Okay, so now it's palm to dorsum. I'm interlacing. I'm capping. I'm cleaning my thumb and then my wrist. I'm not going to do a surgical procedure, but with the COVID, we are using a surgical glove. It's not meant for my coverall. So with the social hand washing, it ranges between 20 to 60 seconds. But you can even use just 20, sometimes less than 20, when you practice and you become what? Perfect. The coverall too has sizes, so you should know your size. And then one thing you have to check is the zip line. Because when you are removing it and the zip line is not good, you'll be struggling. And then you end up what? Contaminating yourself. So this is the coverall. To touch the ground, that's why you do it at the low risk area in the what? A clean place. It's not meant for clean procedure, although help me. That's why you need a supervisor. And then I'll pull. Please take your time, don't rush. The disposable. Then, today I want to feel good, so I want my supervisor to tie it for me. I can tie it myself, I want to feel best. I pour this here, I'm dipping my fingers again. Palm to palm. Palm to dorsum. Interlacing. Capping. My thumb. And then my wrist. In some cases, you can wear examination glove under and wear the surgical glove on top. I feel like putting on two surgical gloves. So this glove says we should tear. So I'm tearing. I've checked the date, the expiry date. I've checked the pack is intact. And then I'm going to tear it. You make sure that your fingers are well fitted. And then you check for what? Holes in the glove. So if you do this and it tells you that the glove is no good, don't hesitate.